So then, we are back with more understandings from the Renewed Covenant, from the Aramaic English translation of the word. And it is very important these days having this fact of having the saved Hebrews return to their camps. It was the plan of the Creator. And the area can be found in Yehuda, shows when the people, they were underway, and they were forming then another holy land. It is very imperative as Gentiles always to then encourage them to return to their camps, because the time is reducing, the time of vengeance is coming, and they are in fact told by the Creator to return to their camps. It is a time where then the deceit is ending, the real service is showing up, and the first service was then completed, the second service then is active, and it must be then completed and exercised and then perfected. So then later, when they receive then the second anointing, so then they can do their work as they were told to do. And there are lots of areas where then Shaul, he explains areas of this service, but mostly you can find this area related in the Hebrews, the 7th chapter, and then the 12th verse states a very interesting portion of it, because then people can understand what it meant in terms of the services. So the 12th verse states, "But as there is a change in the priestly line, so also there is a change in instructions of the Levites." If you're not familiar with the instruction of the tabernacle, then you have no chance, because this is what was then given by the Creator Himself. He wanted the second service updated to the utmost, and they did it at first. So then the second service, then the updates are then given, and at the moment what is only lacking is the second anointing. This is going to be the next updating of the second service. The second anointing is coming. However, the first anointing yet must be perfected in each camp. As we understand then from Revelation, we understand those were then seven camps, cities. Because in each camp they were then involved with the second service. So then reading further, then Shaul explains other areas of the Levitical updates and the priestly line. So what we then understand as then religious, there was never a religious part of it, simply a second service updated when he came, the Creator Himself. So then when we begin to relate of these last days that we are living in, coming towards the Revelation, then we understand from the 20th chapter, 9th verse, states very plainly, "And they went in the breath of the earth, and they encircled the camps and the beloved city." Then you understand, camps, that's plural, the camps of the Hebrews. And that's future, many years in advance. If you then return to the area where we are at, and they are not yet in great numbers returning to their camps, what do you think is going to take place? They must return to their camps and then complete the second service, so then the second anointing comes. So that's where we are at. Please stay tuned, much more coming up.